MSI. It's been a while. Hi, and welcome back to This Bytes For You. So you may have seen that I've been recently having some issues with another X570 board. So in my panic, I went ahead and bought the MSI MEG X570 Ace motherboard. Without wasting much time, let's go ahead, start the unboxing, and I'll talk you through as we're doing the unboxing. All right, so here we are again, the MSI MEG X570 Ace motherboard, AMD socket AM4 X570 chipset, PCIe Gen 4.0 ready, AMD Store My technology. Right. Then along the side here, we can just see basically the same over here. Then also here, a legend letting you know that second and third gen AMD Ryzen, check. Ryzen with Radeon Vega graphics and second gen AMD Ryzen with Radeon graphics, check. Athlon with Radeon Vega graphics, A series Athlon X4. All right. Then along the top, just a few things they support in different languages. Coming along the side over here, kind of going the same thing we saw on the other side. Then over here, serial number, model number, all that good stuff. Then along the back, just some marketing stuff, letting you know features, specifications, and all that good stuff. So let's open her up real quick. All right, so right here we have the motherboard. I'm just going to lift it and move it out of the way just for now, but we'll get back to it. All right, so first off, we have this big old pamphlet talking about True Gaming, their monitors, their video cards, peripherals, headphones, mice, keyboards, all MSI good stuff here. Then here we have the driver's CD. First off, chances are you're probably not going to have a CD or DVD ROM, but if you do, kind of just throw this away. You're always going to want to download the latest and greatest from MSI's website or AMD's. Then a card over here thanking you for choosing MSI products. Nothing along the back here. So then over here we have a bunch of stickers. These are used to wrap around cables and that way you can mark what they are. Like this picture shows here, boot disk, connecting one side to the SATA port, the other side to a hard drive or an SSD. Same thing with the optical over here. Kind of nice. Then over here, a quick installation guide. Kind of going over basics, but don't worry. I'm going to show you from the ground up how to build with this motherboard, how to build a brand new gaming rig or office rig, whatever you want it to be. So very generic information. Definitely good for reference though. Then an MSI MEG X570 Ace user guide. Definitely this will have plenty of good information and also basic guides on how to install RAM, CPU, and all that good stuff. One of the best things in this manual is how to connect the front panel headers for your case, but I'll show you all of that in the build guide, so stay tuned for that. And nothing else in here. Let me just make sure. Yeah, nothing else in here. Then they have this accessory bag. Kind of nice. Okay, so starting off, they have two M.2 screws for your SSDs. I'm going to go ahead, open one up to show you what's inside. You can see that right over here. And again, there's two of them. There might be more, but right now, all I see is two. And then an MSI True Gaming badge. Then they bring... Wow, okay. Four SATA cables. And then these are the kind of SATA cables. Actually, they're mixed bags. So two of the cables are going to be the straight cables that have the metal locking mechanism. A lot of you ask, you know, where do you find the SATA cables? Of course, you can buy them, but they typically come with the motherboard. So there'll be two of those, and then the other one that there'll be two of is the SATA cable that one end is straight and the other end has a bend, a 90 degree bend. So definitely to help with some cable management. Then over here they have extension cables, a 1-2 RGB LED extension Y cable, and goes out to 4-pin right over here. And there's two of those cables here. That's awesome that they include it. Then they have a rainbow RGB LED extension cable. Then they also include a Corsair RGB LED extension cable, 3-pin over here. Then one of my favorite accessories on any motherboard is the Wi-Fi adapter. Now this isn't just any Wi-Fi adapter. This is the Intel Wi-Fi 6. Maybe it goes this way. No, it goes this way. There we go. Their Wi-Fi 6 AX200. Two connections right over here for the back of the board. This supports 802.11 A, B, G, N, AC, AX, MUMIMU, RX, and 2.4 gigahertz through 5 gigahertz up to 2.4 gigabits per second. So that is pretty awesome. And it looks like those are all the accessories. So let me put this stuff away so that we can focus on the motherboard itself. Oh, and actually, before I get to the board, it comes with three of these M.2 screws. All right, so removing tape. All right, and then coming out of the bag, this is the board itself. Play hard, stay silent. Makes me giggle a little bit. All right, I need to keep this. And all right, so we can see a chipset fan right back here. Now, they go down very easily, but that's okay. So then blocking over here, there's going to be 1, 2, 3 M.2 slots. And they have very nice heat shields. And I really like their implementation of it, as opposed to Asus's. So we can see the heat shield right over here. And to protect the sticker, all right, we can see that. Looks nice. Lightning Gen 4 M.2. Along the back here, a thermal pad right over here. It's covered, but we'll use that a little bit later on. Now, the reason I was mentioning that it was better than Asus's is Asus has a screw here and a screw here. And it's kind of difficult to find exactly where both screws go. And then over here, you would just screw in one, let's say, right over here. Then the other side goes right into here. So that is an interesting design. So it just goes right in here. Oh, I see. So that's nice. This piece slides right into here. And then it slides right here, right into the screws, so you don't have to spend 10 minutes looking for those screws. Awesome implementation, MSI. Then over here, they have pads so that you don't touch the M.2 to the base of the board. Now, coming around the board, we'll find two 8-pin EPS connections on the top left-hand corner of the board. Then we'll find CPU fan number one, pump fan number one, a JRGB connection, a J Corsair 1 connection, system fan 4, system fan 2, system fan 5, an ATX 24-pin connection, USB 3.0, 4 SATA ports, a J front panel 2, J front panel 1, right over here, the diagnostic LED. This will tell you your BIOS postcodes or the temperature of your CPU. Right down here, a very cool feature, the power button, the reset button, and then the game boost knob to allow you to overclock your CPU for any given profile. Pretty cool feature. We'll also find along the bottom here a USB Type-C connection, another USB 3.0, USB 2.0, another USB 2.0 header. Then we'll find here the J Power LED connection, another system fan 3, system fan 1, a J Rainbow 2 connection, front panel audio, then we'll find a TPN header connection, and then we'll find three PCIe 4.0 by 16 slots, of course, backwards compatible with 3.0. Then we'll also find two PCIe by 1 slots with 7 fan headers and support for MSI Mystic Light Infinity. Then we'll find here 4 DIMM slots supporting dual channel DDR4 up to 5000 plus megahertz, of course overclocked up to 128 gigs. Then an AM4 socket right over here. For the rear I/O, we have the flash BIOS button. That way if you have a CPU that isn't supported by the BIOS, you can do a BIOS flashback right over here. Then we have a clear CMOS. Then here's where you'll connect those two Wi-Fi 6 AX200 connections. Here you'll find two USB 2.0 ports. One of those two is for that BIOS flashback. Then oddly enough, you'll find a PS2 port. Haven't seen those in a while. Then we'll find here two USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, a USB Type-C Gen 2 port, USB 3.2, and then a USB 3.2 Gen 2 port Type-A. Then right over here, we'll find the Intel WGI211AT Gigabit LAN. Then right over here, the Realtek RTL8125 2.5 gigabits per second LAN. Awesome. As well as two USB 3.2 Gen 2 ports. Then over here, we'll find the HD audio connectors for 7.1 channel HD audio with an optical SPDIF utilizing a Realtek ALC1220 Codec. So the MSI MEG Ace X570 has a ton of cool features. And here on This Bytes For You, you're going to see me build up this entire system, flash the BIOS, configure the BIOS, install the OS. And then also, as a side note, I didn't want to do a separate unboxing for it, but we're going to be utilizing the AMD Ryzen 9 5900X processor. Definitely a sweet processor. So stick around, make sure to click like and subscribe. It helps me out a ton to keep bringing you bigger and better products just like this. Now, I will have to say, I bought all of this on my own dime. The money that comes into This Bytes For You, everything comes right back into the channel. So on that note, don't forget, if you'd like, go ahead, buy me a cup of coffee too. As I just mentioned, I put everything back into the channel. So that's it for now. Iggy with This Bytes For You out. See you guys.